In my today's tutorial, I will show you how to make this very beautiful and very easy crochet hot pad or pot holder or simply a showpiece or a coaster. Hi, I'm Shaburi from hookedinloops.com. I make various kind of crafts tutorials in my channel. So please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon and don't forget to like, share and comment. So we will use 4-ply acrylic yarn or cotton yarn and a 3mm crochet hook for this project. So we will take the yarn and at first we will be making a magic circle. You will be getting my beginner's crochet tutorials in my playlist, so check them out if you are a beginner. After you have made the magic circle, just do chain 3. This chain 3 is the first double crochet stitch of this round. Then in the magic circle we will be doing a total of 14 double crochet stitches. So chain 3 and 14 double crochet stitches in this first round. So a total of 15 double crochets, taking the first chain 3 as a double crochet. I hope you understood. So chain 3 and 14 double crochets in the magic circle. When you are done with your stitches, just pull the tail of the magic circle to close the circle and we will complete this round with a slip stitch in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this round in this manner. So the first round is done. We will begin the second round with a chain 3. This chain 3 is the first double crochet stitch of this second round. Then in the same stitch where you slip stitch, just insert your hook there and do a double crochet there. So we did a chain 3 and a double crochet. Then in the next stitch we will be doing 2 double crochet stitches, that is an increase. And similarly in all the remaining stitches we will be doing 2 double crochets in each one of those. Okay, so this round will contain a total of 29 double crochets and a chain 3. And we will complete this round with a slip stitch in the third chain of the starting chain 3 followed by chain 1 and we will cut the yarn. So our first circle is ready. In this manner we will be making a total of 6 circles. Okay, so all the 6 circles are ready. Now we will just join them. I have chosen a contrasting colored yarn, made a slip knot and inserted the hook in it. Then we will insert our hook in any stitch of both the circles in this manner and join them with a slip stitch as I am showing you, followed by a chain 1 to secure the slip stitch. Okay, then we will take the first circle and we will be doing 1 single crochet in the following 10 stitches one by one. So 1 single crochet in each of the following 10 stitches as I'm showing you. And after that we will insert our hook in the 11th stitch of the first circle and also in the 11th stitch of the next circle in this manner and join them using a slip stitch followed by chain 1 to secure the slip stitch like this, and turn our work and we will be doing 1 single crochet in each of the following stitches of the second circle in this manner. And when you have done the single crochet stitches in the 10 stitches, just take the third circle. We will place our circles in this manner. Then we will take a third circle and just insert your hook in the first stitch of the second circle and in any stitch of the third circle as I am going to show you. Insert your hook in the first stitch where you began of the second circle and also in any stitch of the third circle, and we will join them by doing a slip stitch followed by chain 1, and we will continue as earlier. So we will be doing one single crochet in each of the following 10 stitches of the second circle, one by one. And when you have reached the 11th stitch, just insert your hook in the 11th stitch and also in the 11th stitch of the third circle. Okay, just count them and insert your hook in the 11th stitch and just join them by doing a slip stitch followed by a chain 1, and turn your work and start doing one single crochet in each of the 10 stitches of the third circle as you did earlier. Isn't the pattern easy? And when you have done your last single crochet stitch, we will bring the fourth circle and join them in this manner, one by one. So all the circles have been joined. We will now be joining the first and the sixth circle. So insert your hook in the first stitch of the sixth circle and the first stitch of the first circle where you began, and do a slip stitch there to join them, followed by chain 1, and then take the sixth circle and start doing one single crochet in each of the following 10 stitches, one by one. And then we will insert our hook in the 11th stitch and also in the 11th stitch of the first circle. We have marked that with a stitch marker, and just join them by a slip stitch followed by chain 1, and then turn your work and start doing one single crochet in each of the following 10 stitches of the first circle as usual. Isn't the pattern easy? Just comment it in the comment section if you found it easy, and if you found this difficult, just mention that in the comment section. And at the end, insert your hook in the first stitch of the first circle, do a slip stitch there, then do a chain 1, cut the yarn, and we will just weave in the loose end. Now we will be doing a border to our circle, that is border to our outer circle. For that, we will take the pink colored yarn, make a slip knot and insert the hook in it. We will insert our hook in any stitch of the outer circle. So I have inserted the hook in the stitch where I joined two circles. Okay, just do a slip stitch there at first. Secure the slip stitch with a chain 1. In the same stitch, we will do a single crochet stitch. Then one by one, we will be doing one single crochet stitch in each of the following stitch of the outer circle. Just don't skip any stitch, okay? So in this manner, we will continue stitching our outer circle to give it a beautiful border. And slowly we will complete our work in this manner. Isn't this looking beautiful? You can play with your own choice of colors and enjoy your artwork. So we have reached the end of this round. We will simply do a slip stitch in the first single crochet stitch of this round, followed by a chain 1, and we will just cut the yarn, and our pattern is complete. I hope you like this pattern and it was easy to follow. This is beautiful as well as easy, and a perfect home decor for your kitchen and your dining space. I hope you like this tutorial and it was easy for you to follow. If you like this tutorial, then please hit the like button, comment in the comment section for any queries. Also mention if you want to see any other kind of videos, I will make those for you. And thank you and have a great day, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.